Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The next presentation is the nine confluence competition that will be presented by Art Middeldorp. Okay, Art.
Yes, thank you, and welcome to this live competition. So this This competition runs live for 1 hour. For those of you who cannot wait, I mean, if you click on this link, you get a view to the live view page, which looks like this. And in this 1 hour talk, I will explain how this is set up, how to read this, and my assistant Fabian will now start the competition, and we will come back to this during the meeting to watch the progress. So let's go back to the slides. So the names on the slides are the steering committee members of COCO. So Kirak Shintani, Naoki Nishida, and Johannes Waldman. Then this talk is structured as follows. So I give the acknowledgements up front, then I explain the history of the competition, and then the exciting part is to follow the real-time development in the third block. And in this third block, also the tool authors have the opportunity to give a short presentation about their own tool. Right, so this competition is not possible without people who write software to establish confluence and related properties. So that's always a big effort, and the competition is an opportunity to get acknowledgement for that. So that's the most important acknowledgement. And until 2019, Julian Nagle was involved in running the thing on Star Exec. And for those in the know, running things on Star Exec is tedious, to say the least. And luckily this year, Fabian took over and he is actually controlling the Star Exec interface. Then the chairs, Mauricio and Samuel, to allow the competition to run live during IWC. Because that gives the right community to watch this competition. I come back to that later. Then we have a panel who plays an important role in evaluating the results and commenting on the tool output. And this year that's Frederic Blonky, Cynthia Kopp, and Geoff Sutcliffe. Right, so let's start with the history, but before that, let's make sure that the competition is really running. So I go back to the competition view. And a big relief, we see colors, green and blue. So indeed the competition is running. And how to read this, if we look at up left block, that's the main TRS category. And that the task is simply to prove or disprove confluence of 100 random problems. And as you can see here, there are a number of participating tools. So one tool, the winner of last year, that was ACP 2019. Then there is a new version of ACP. There is ColdSciGava and there is CSI. And then the colored frames below, green means the number of yeses that were obtained. In blue, the number of nos. And in dark gray, the number of maybes. And then light gray, the problems that were not yet tested. And yeah, this runs in a random way. So it's not that we first do TRS and then people interested in CPF category have to wait until the end. So this all runs in parallel. Okay, back to the slides. So the history, so this competition started the same year as IWC was founded. It was during RTA in Nagoya 2012. And in the first year of the competition, we had the main TRS category. an immediately certified category, because we all know software tools are buggy. And to ensure correctness of the output, we have certified categories. And so in 2012, it was very much a Japanese-Austrian activity. So ACP, at that time in Tohoku, Sendai, CSI from Innsbruck, Saigawa from Kanazawa, and CETA was the certifier used in connection with CSI for the certified category. Then 1 year later, no developments, except the tools were developed. But in 2014, we added conditional rewriting in the conditional CTRS category. And again, participation from Austria and Japan, Austria. So CO3 was developed at Nagoya and Vienna at that time. And a new tool from Kanazawa, CALL, participated. Then in 2015, the competition grew with new categories for higher order rewriting, for ground confluence, and for nominal rewrite systems. That's the NRS category. And there were new tools. Saigawa merged with CALL for the TRS category, and we had higher order tools, CSI, HO, and ACPH. Then Coast Guard was in Vienna for conditional rewriting, ground confluence prover, a version of ACP, and NOCO was a nominal confluence prover developed in Tohoku. But still very much an Austria-Japan activity that stayed until 2016, when we introduced the category unique normal forms. And for conditional rewrite system certification started, again with CETA as background tool, but CONCON decided to certify its output. And we had a new decision tool appearing for it. 2017, the unique normal form category was split into three subcategories, all having to do with variants of the unique normal form property. And the other thing is there was a new higher order tool, SOL, participating in the HRS category. So it's very much an Austria-Japan thing, this COCO. But then in 2018, no new categories, but one offer from Innsbruck moved to London and took the higher order CSI with him. So that's now a British tool. Finally, international competition. And then in 2019, so last year, we introduced three new categories, namely commutation, com, which we heard about earlier in this program, inf, that's for infeasibility checking, that has lots of applications, for instance, checking satisfiability of conditions in conditional rewrite systems. And we have a subclass of the TRS category, the SRS systems, so string rewrite systems. Because of that string rewrite system, we have a new tool, NOCO Leipzig, developed by Johannes Waldman, a specialist in string rewriting. And in INF, we have a new Spanish tool last year, INF Checker, and many tools, new tools from Austria and Japan. So that's the history. So some remarks on the competition. I already mentioned COCO runs live on StarExec. Actually, COCO is the very first competition that moved to StarExec. It's exciting to watch. So this is a view of last year when we run in Prague during two Olympics. And there was no IWC, so there were no people interested in Confluence. So we practiced already for this virtual event. So you can see here social distancing, very few people present. And it was also exciting because we had, yes, no conflicts. And that is always exciting. And then the steering committee and the panel members have to become active during the competition to figure out who is right, who is wrong. So last year we had conflicts in the infeasibility categories, so one of the new categories. We had conflicts in commutation category, was also a new category. And for first time, I think, we had a yes-no conflict in the main TRS category. And so it will be exciting to watch this year whether these conflicts disappeared, whether new conflicts are happening. Okay, before we look at the results, the final slide of last year contained this information, so most likely in Paris co-located. We have separate yes and no results, so until now we take the combined count of yes and no, and that determines the winner. And because we had so many new tools in feasibility category, we decided to split this. Still, the main winner is the combined yes, no, but we have separate rankings for yes and for no. And I announced there will be a new t-shirt for participating tool offers. So last year we had this t-shirt, and yeah, this looks like a confluence diagram. And this was inspired by an earlier COCO where we had a yes-no conflict in higher order rewriting. So you see here an exploding confluence diagram where the lambdas are coming out of the volcano and coconuts are running out. And of course, the point of confluence is to find a common redux. So that was last year. For this year, because it's a virtual event, we didn't make the effort to make a t-shirt, but we do have an official design for COCO 2020. So that's probably the highlight in this presentation. Okay, so before we come to the setup of this year and the two presentations, let's have a look at the progress. Okay, so we are making good progress. So we have 1/3 in the TRS category. And if we look at this, it's CSI and ACP are close. I mean, you can most clearly see that in the percentages, 27 for ACP last year, 22 this year. That doesn't mean that this year is worse than last year. It simply has to do with the scheduling of the problems. Anyway, this is too close to call. TRS in commute, and we don't see any conflicts. Also in commutation, no conflict yet. And here it seems call, Fort, Newfort, and ACP are doing well. SRS category, CSI is strong in no, ACP is strong in yes, so that will be exciting. HRS, we have the new SOLT tool making a reappearance, and that seems ahead of CSI higher order. Conditional rewrite systems, where last year we had all these conflicts, it seems to be close between ACP and CO3, 25-24%. Infeasibility was dominated by InfChecker last year. It was at that time the only tool that said no, but now we see ConCon and NonReach produce no answers. But still, InfChecker seems to be slightly ahead. Then the UN category is the one with the most participants is UNC, and there I would expect ACP to be ahead because of their new decision procedure. For ground confluence, AGCP is far ahead of Ford, that's no surprise. And the certified categories, in CTRS, we have only one participant, which seems worse than last year, but again, that's a scheduling thing, I believe. And in certified TRS, I think CSI has more certified support than ACP, so there's no surprise. In the window below, you see the current rewrite system that is being analyzed. And you also see tools are way faster than humans can probably process these problems. Okay, so that's a few of the current results. So let's go back to the presentation. Right, can you see this? I think so. So, right, so the categories are the same as last year. I already mentioned, so TRS is the oldest category that's plain first on the term rewriting, and the task is to prove or disprove confluence. There is a certified version of this category, and in the live competition, the problems that are given to the TRS tools are exactly the same problems as for the certified category. That's also true for CTRS and CPF CTRS. Then HRS, higher order, GCR, ground confluence, and we all know ground confluence is harder than confluence, because in confluence, for plain rewriting, we have Newman's lemma. So termination implies decidability, and in the ground case, termination is not sufficient for decidability. Then the unique normal form properties, we have a version with respect to reduction and with respect to conversion, and a variant called the normal form property. Commutation, we heard about infeasibility and confluence. Okay, let's move to the participating tools. So this was the view of last year. This year we have exactly the same categories, but there is a change in the tools. So unfortunately, we lost NoCo Leipzig. So Johannes decided not to participate this year, but we hope he will be back next year. But it's very good that Sol is back in the run. So for many years, CSI, HO ran unopposed, and now we have Sol back. And the other change, Ford, has been completely re-implemented in Haskell, so now it's called Ford H. Okay, the rules of the competition. So we have 100 random problems per category coming from the Confluence Problems database. This is random selection based on seed digits provided by the panel members. So that's an important role of the panel. The tools output yes or no, or maybe in the first line, and then some human readable explanation. I already mentioned this year we have separate yes and no rankings in addition to the usual combined yes-no answers. And also to measure progress, the winning tools of last year participate as demonstration tools this year. So they cannot win, but they are used to measure progress. Okay, next. In addition to the problems from the database, we have the option that tool offers and other people interested in Confluence submit secret problems. They will be selected. So typically a tool offer thinks the tool is very good on this particular kind of problem, and then to control the competition, you submitted a secret problem. However, to avoid that such behavior dominates the competition, we have per tool a maximum of 2 secret problems per category. And this year, yeah, maybe due to late announcement, we had only 4 secret problems submitted, including the string rewrite rule submitted by Johannes Waldman. ABA goes to AAB, AB. So this is not terminating. ABA appears embedded on the right, and confluence is difficult. Okay, what happens in case of conflict? So we have the following rule in COCO. So tools that produce incorrect results, either because of conflicts in the yes in the live run, or because tool offers are honest and communicated to the steering committee afterwards, and that does indeed happen, they cannot be winners. So they are then removed from the results table. In addition, after the competition, we have a full run of all tools on the whole database, typically 1 week after the competition. Moreover, the tools that run in the competition corrected in case conflicts are observed, are put into this nice web tool, COCO Web, which is available to everyone for testing state-of-the-art tools on their problems. So here we see an example, so you can enter this, or you can enter a problem from the COPS database. Then you can select on the left which tools of which years to run on which property. You can set the timeout. And then after waiting, you get for each tool you selected a special tab with the corresponding output. So this is very good to test problems that you put into your articles. Okay, and we have COPS, developed mainly by now Hirokawa, and it's very nicely set up with lots of good functionality to select sub-problems. And yeah, the link you can easily find. Okay, that was basically the main introduction. So now we come to the tool presentations. But before that, let's have a quick look at the progress in the competition. Right, so, okay, we are quick, we are up more than halfway. So in TRS, it's too close to call if you compare ACP and CSI 50-51. In COM, call is 28-27-32, too close to call. CSI, SOL makes a very solid impression here. CTRS, CONCON takes the lead. InfChecker, like last year, is ahead, but not as much, I would say, as last year. So in particular, non-reach is going for the second place. In UNC, ACP is ahead, both yes and no. In ground confluence, of course, ACP is ahead of Ford. Right, so all is going well. And in particular, and that's maybe a bit disappointing, we don't have yet any conflicts. So maybe tools got more reliable. Okay, back to the presentation. Right, so let's look at the results. And now the way I do this, I go through each of the category, present a ranking of last year, and then we have slides by the tool office, and I try to give them access to the screen. Okay, so in the main TRS category last year, we had incorrect answers by Kol Saigawa, so that's not listed on the podium. And ACP switched places with CSI. So typically in TRS, it's a close run between ACP and CSI, like this year. Okay, so now I give access, or rather, AutoSum is present. Please start talking. AutoSum, are you there? I don't hear anything. Auto. Okay, well, I mean, of course, ACP has been around a long time, so I can also present this. Auto enters, so with ACP enters the main TRS category in the certified TRS category in UNC. That's their specialty, so it's also shown here at the bottom. So tomorrow, the first regular talk at FSED is about a new decision procedure for UNC, so please watch. They participate in conditional term rewriting, in commutation, and in string rewriting. It's written in standard ML, so they started development in 2009. 10 years later, they are at version 0.7, so maybe, yeah. Room maybe 1.7. Okay, they implement lots of direct methods and divide and conquer methods. And for UNC, they present a new technique tomorrow. And for TRS, as written here, they couldn't make any new efforts. Okay, that's about ACP. Maybe there are questions to ACP. I mean, feel free to interrupt this presentation at any time. And we move then forward with Cole Saigaba.
Hi.
Okay, so I give permission to Shintani or to now.
Now. Okay. Cole Saigaba.
Okay, start my video. Okay, Koro Saigawa is a combination of two conference provers. One is Koro, which is actually commutation prover for first order term rewriting. So if system is left linear, Koro is used for showing conference. And I'm not sure. Okay, and if system is non-left linear, and then conference tool Saigawa is used for showing conference. Right, and yeah, what's new in this competition? Yeah, Yeah, in as a backend tool, this tool uses mini SMT, not Z3, but this year, Koro Saigawa no longer uses TTT2 for showing termination. Why? Yeah, because TTT2 is actually equivalent tool to CSI, which is our competitor. Right. Okay, go next. Okay, yeah, thanks. Yeah, what's the new feature? Next. Next slide.
Yeah, okay, I will do the clicking.
Okay, yeah, I mean, we corrected bugs in AC method, and the next. Right, we supported Oyamaguchi and Ota's upside parallel closedness, as well as outside closedness. Next one. Yeah, right, this is a corresponding theorem, and the next. Right, this is another one, outside one. Okay, next. Right, also we supported Toyama's parallel critical pair based conference criterion, and also Okui's simultaneous closedness theorem. Okay, next, could you show? Okay, so yeah, this is actually corresponds to Shintani's talk, and the next one, could you show me? Right, so this is simultaneous theorem. Right, yeah, that's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Then we move to CSI that will be presented by Fabian. So I give you mouse control.
Good afternoon. I hope everyone can hear me.
Yes.
Good. All right, CSI.
I can also click.
All right. So this is a picture of the location which gives its name to CSI. This is the confluence of two rivers, the Sil River coming from the south here and the Inn River coming from the west. And not far from this location, the CSI tool was born. And this year we are competing with the version 1.2.4. So CSI is an open source tool for confluence and related properties. for anyone who wants to use it, but not download the source or the executable. It comes with a convenient web interface, and both the web interface, the source, and the executable, all three, can be found at this URL here. CSI has, as mentioned, competed last year in these six categories, and we won four of these. That is the certified TRS, NFP, UNR, and SRS categories. This year, we're competing in the same categories with small changes and new features. The first being we implemented a new criterion for confluence of upside parallel closed rewrite systems based on this paper by Yamaguchi and Ota. And we've also improved the performance of the strategy for certified confluence and confluence. Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. So let's look at live TRS category. Maybe it's already over the competition. No, it's okay, there are a few problems left to be given to the tools, and it's very close. ACP is slightly ahead of CSI, and Call is a bit behind, but still too close to tell the outcome. Okay, let's move on to the next category. And that will be the certified TRS category. So there are two tools I already mentioned, ACP and CSI. Both provide facilities to produce certificates which are checked by CETA. So is there any CETA offer in the audience? I don't see René, I don't see Jonas, okay. Akihisa, no. Chris, no. Okay, so I then present. Well, CETA is a well-known tool based on or co-generated from Isabel, and it started as a certifier for termination, but in the meantime, it can handle confluence proofs, it can handle completion, many, many other things. It's freely available on this link. The main development last year, which will be presented, I think, by René Tiemann tomorrow in his invited FACD ICHCAR talk, will be support for the weighted path order, this very powerful simplification order invented by Yamada-san. And this might affect future certification efforts in the Confluence category. So hopefully NAT will start doing Confluence. Right, that about CETA. Then the CTRS category, that was always, we had CONCON, we had CO3, and then only last year or 2 years ago, ACP joined. And last year we had the surprising win by ECP because both CONCON and CO3 were disqualified due to wrong output. Right, so CO3, Nishida-san, I give you access.
Okay, can you hear me? So my tool CO3 is a converter for proving confluence of conditional termly light systems. So our technique is based on unraveling the transformation from conditional to unconditional. And to prove confluence, our criteria implemented is very simple. So we implemented orthogonality and termination and critical pair lemma. So and for termination, we implemented a simple dependency pair framework and reduction order with based on size. But the number of our solution would be nice enough. And moreover, last year we implemented a narrowing tree to solve, so to prove infeasibility of conditions. And then this year, I improved slightly termination criteria. So the computation of SCC. So this is my introduction of CO3. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. All right. And we come to Konkon. Right. Konkon, Christian is not joining, it seems. But I know this tool quite well. So this is developed in Innsbruck over many years. Current version 1.2. 10, it started with ABCU and N is new. And in the meantime, it has this new feature presented in the PhD thesis of Thomas Ternagel about removal of infeasible rules from the system. That is a useful technique. Inlining is a useful technique to simplify the problems. And since last year, it also joins the infeasibility category where it is based on non-reachability analysis. And I think what is new this year is that they use a tool split off from Konkon called non-reach by Florian Messner as external infeasibility tool. So like CSI, it's open source. You can download it from this URL and it participates in the conditional rewrite category, also in the certified version of that and in the infeasibility category. Okay, higher order. That was boring last year because there was only one participating tool, CSI higher order. So we called for more participation and this year that had effect because this year we have two tools, CSI HO and SOL. Okay, Julian, I didn't see in the list of participants, but yeah, it's the same location. So it's the SIL and the IN providing this confluence point and yeah, if you don't look too close, it looks like lambda, so it's natural to do higher order there. And it works for higher order pattern systems. It's available from this link. Also the CSI web interface supports the higher order version. And there were no new features in 2020. But then we have SOL, so I give a screen right to Hamanasan.
Okay. So the SOL is a Haskell-based tool for analyzing confluence and termination. And the authors of this tool is at myself and Kikuchi-san at Tohoku University and Date Yao. And Fuju in Gumi University. And the related differences of the SOL tool is the recent publication in the Science of Computer Programming and also in Journal of Functional Programming. So in these papers, so we have written related techniques used in SOL. But basically the SOL doesn't use very tricky techniques on proving confluence. The basic idea is just to use the Knuth and Bendix critical pair checking. But we have extended this to deal with new pattern of the rewrite system, namely the higher, function as constructor patterns can be used in the higher order rules. So this is one of the point of the feature of SOL. And for the strong normalization, so the SOL uses the Frederick's general schema criterion. And yes, due to so the general schema criterion, so the termination checking is rather faster than the other tools. So because of this, maybe Also the confluence checking, the speed of the checking is faster than other tools. So this is one of the, I think, a good point. And also, yes, and both confluence and termination, so Sorry uses a certain modularity technique to divide a large problem into smaller parts. And so finally, so so now currently the SOAR is not available as a standalone tool. So, but so we have we have the web-based web-based interface for the SOAR. So please visit our homepage. Just Google my name. Then maybe you can use our tool SOAR for checking your termination or complex problem. But if you are interested in our tool, please contact me. So maybe so we can work with together. Yes, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Amana-san. Then, oops, how do I get control? We go to ground confluence. There we have ACP, which was already introduced in FORT in 2019. And last year we had a problem in the selection of the problems due to a mistake by the steering committee. And you can see that if I share this other window. Right, in COPS, COCO, we have this very nice view of all previous competition results, including the live run and full run. And if you go to the 2019 GCR category, you can clearly see, I mean, we had 100 problems as usual, but only very few could be handled by the participating tools. So that we know test only when running the live view, and this year we tested this properly. Okay, then so FORT will be introduced later. AutoSum is still present, but does he hear us? I mean, we should of course mention in Japan it's close to 10 p.m. I think. So he is excused of speaking. Right, so AGCP is a ground confluence prover. It's like ACP written in SML. It's based on methods that were presented at earlier MACD conferences. So rewriting induction is a main technique. They have these proving methods and some transformations for ground confluence. And right, so MACD 2017, if you want to know more about the tool, and there were no new developments. Okay, NFP, that's not so interesting. UNR, okay, conditional certification. There's only one tool, CONCON, that provides certificates, of course, that wins. UNC ACP has specialized techniques, which will be presented tomorrow. And this was the other surprise last year. We had this new commutation category with ACP and COL. And COL is a designated commutation-based confluence prover. And we have FORT that is a decision tool for a limited fragment. And surprisingly, last year, FORT won this category because the other tools were buggy. Okay, so we come to the presentation of COL. Shintani-san, I will give you
okay.
Mouse access.
Okay, COL is commutation tool for left linear TRSs. Please go to the slide.
Okay, I click.
Thank you. One slide, please. One more slide, please. Okay. It is based on divide and conquer approach. First, it has several direct commutation criteria, and if proving directly is failed, then try to find the commuting subsystems. And please go to next slide. Yes, left linearity is often essential. And this version is, we supported several closeness criteria. For commutation, we support almost parallel closeness in Toyama 1988. And we also support self-commutation version conference criteria to use self-commutation. It is fourth criteria. Toyama's 81's criterion based on parallel critical pairs and simultaneous closeness, Oku's 1988, and also Oyama, Gucci, and Ota's upside parallel closeness. And outside closeness supported. As Hirokawa-sensei took, we also improve HD-related feature. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, final participant to be presented is Fort H. Fabian, please.
So Fort H is a re-implementation of the previous Fort tool, and the H stands for Haskell here. Next slide, please. So FORTH is a decision tool, and as such, it takes as input a TRS and a property, and it outputs if this property holds for the given TRS. Now, as a property, it can take an arbitrary formula in the first order theory of rewriting. So it can not only do properties related to confluence, of course, but many more. And back, please. And the TRSs are limited to linear variable separated TRSs and cannot do arbitrary TRSs. Last year, Ford competed, not Ford H, and it competed in these five categories. And to our surprise, it won the COM category. Ford H will compete in the same categories, but it is slightly different than Ford. The differences are here. It's based on a modified version of the decision procedure. It also supports linear variable separated TRSs instead of only left linear right ground TRSs. Due to that modified decision procedure, it supports a more expressive theory. Here is an example. It, for example, supports the predicate of rewriting below the root, which was not possible in FORT previously. And the goal of the tool is to at some point produce fully certified proofs. And this is some ongoing work for the formalization effort here. And the tool is available at the FORT website as a binary at the moment. Thank you very much.
Okay, I was of course wrong. There are more tools to be presented because of the infeasibility category. So last year, InfChecker dominated, followed by NonReach and Mocha. So there were six tools, the highest ever, participating in the COCO category. COCO was disqualified, and last year, InfChecker was the only tool that could say no. Right, so now I hope the InfCheck offers are participating. I don't see Raul and I don't see Salvador. Okay. Well, this slide is obvious. These are the offers, and Raul is now in Madrid. Right, so it can handle the COCO format for infeasibility, but actually InfChecker can handle much more. And I will not say more about this because in Ichka later this week there is a presentation about all this by the tool authors. So please watch that if you want to know more about InfoChecker. It's available via this link. It's written in Haskell and right. So watch at Ichka. That's this paper, the first reference. But so really this is the dominating tool in this category. Then we have Mocha 0.2, Hirokawa-san.
Okay, this tool is actually completion tool for given infeasibility problem, Mocha transform it into word problem. So basically infeasibility problem can be solved by finding a counter model. Our tool transform it into a word problem. And we construct a complete related system as a initial model for it. But actually, current completion technique like maximal ordered completion is extremely powerful, but we cannot find a suitable complete rewrite system because complete presentation need not to be finite. So this is a problem. Right, so yeah, this is a basic structure of how to prove infeasibility problem. So yeah, these three transformation is used for getting equality system together with some goal. And if T equal false is disproved, infeasibility is concluded. Right, so go next slide. Right, so our technique for improving successful rate of completion is approximation. So go next one. Next slide. Right, so for given such a equational system, actually Mocha, completion procedure doesn't terminate because there is no finite complete system. Mocha actually approximate equational system by replacing some subterm by a fresh variable. And then system admits finite presentation. So actually our system only supports completion and approximation technique. And in this year, we supported some encoding technique to word problem. This is minor point, so let me skip. That's it.
Okay, thank you. Then there is non-reach by Florian Messner, but he is not present. And well, this is the overview of his non-reachability tool. And it uses techniques from termination analysis or estimation of dependency graphs and narrowing techniques to modify problems. It's open source, available via this link. And right, easy interface. It can now handle no results and it can output certificates. So that will be a future development in COCO that we also do certification for infeasibility. Right, and string rewriting. So last year we had this new tool by Johannes Noko Leipzig, which produces the most no answers, but this year decided not to join, although they would still produce the most no answers. Right, so we are almost at the end. So I think the competition has finished in the meantime. So let's have a look at the results and hope there are no conflicts. Okay. Right, so it has indeed finished. So TRS CSI is slightly ahead of ACP, two systems, one yes and one no. Okay, so it's called for CSI, that's a big relief. Commutation order has been restored or not. I mean, ACP is slightly ahead of call and Ford is far behind, but call is better in yes than ACP, okay. SRS, that's the same as last year total, but ACP is ahead of CSI in the yeses. HRS, congratulations to Saul, back with the vengeance, so clearly ahead of CSI HO. CTRS, order is restored, CONCON is far ahead, I would say, in both yes and no over CO3 and ACP. INF, again, INF checker wins, and actually with the same results as last year's tool, but we see CONCON and non-reach, which can now handle no answers, come in second and third. The NFP, CSI ahead of Ford, that's to be expected. UNC, ACP wins clearly. UNR, CSI ahead of Ford, but Ford is better in yes, but it can be due to the selection. Ground confluence, AGCP ahead of Ford H. Certified categories, there was no surprise. Well, there is a surprise, perhaps, in certified termination. This year's combination can handle one more yes than last year. That can be due to the CSI strategy. Or, that's probably the reason. And no, yes, no conflict. So it was maybe not so exciting as it could have been, but the good thing is no conflicts because panel members were absent today from the live view. Okay, that's all the steering committee has to say about the Confluence competition. So we will be back next year, COCO 2021. Of course, in IWC, for instance, in the talk of Frederik, we heard there is interest in higher order with dependent types, so the SC will become active there. And if you are involved or were involved in other categories, say nominal rewriting, it would be nice to add additional countries, so France, Brazil, I mean, we welcome input by the community. Thank you for listening.
Okay, Art, fantastic. And congratulations for the winners. Very nice competition this year without conflicts. And okay.